What up, guys? We're here with Shane from Fight Tips. And if you guys don't know who he is, what would you call yourself? Like a fight YouTuber, martial arts YouTuber? It's someone left their phone on.
I was holding your phone.
Unprofessional. This is not how we usually do things.
Come on, man. I drove all the way here.
I know. What do you call yourself? Like a...
Striking coach. Striking coach. Online coach. YouTuber, social influencer,
yeah,
all those things. How do you answer that question when your grandmother asks?
What do I do?
Yeah,
I say I like to fuck around. That's what I say.
I get so, paid for it.
Yeah, so I'm a big fan of Shane's, and as you guys know, I've been training a lot of martial arts. And I forgot who reached out to who online. We're like, oh, cool, we know who each other are.
Yeah.
That's awesome. And I definitely wanted to train with Shane. Today was a little bit more barbell focused. A little bit of sparring at the end, so stay until the end. Next time I'm gonna go over to his place, but I would love to just maybe like pick your brain and like kind of understand how you got to where you were and where you are. And because I'm really interested in doing one amateur fight.
You are,
but
yeah.
I'm very scared.
Okay.
And I've never wrestled before, so I've done competition. You know, you go up, you don't know who they are, and I've done tournaments where you wrestle like 10 guys in one day, like that kind of stuff.
Big crowds used to that, the nerves and all that kind of
thing. And powerlifting meets are very similar. You know, like you prep like 12 weeks, 8 weeks, 16 weeks for something. You show up, game day, you see the person that like that wants to take you down. There's like, it's very similar.
Yeah.
But I think the one thing that's really, really different is from both wrestling, a wrestling pin is kind of like a knockout. But for some reason, it just doesn't feel like your manhood got taken away if someone just like beat your ass in striking.
Yeah.
So like, how did you get into striking, and how did you like progress like all the way through?
Yeah, so I started Taekwondo 9 years old, and my dad's a black belt in Taekwondo, so he got me into that.
Oh, so you cheated a little bit.
I cheated, yeah, okay. I definitely got grandfathered.
It's your fault, Dad. My dad's a black belt.
Is he?
No, he never even started.
He's got a black leather belt.
Yeah.
Hold his pants up.
Yeah.
So I was doing point competitions where, you know, you land a strike and then the judges stop it and the first person at 3 strikes, and I was like, this is cool. I'm in that environment, like you said, the competition world, but I wanted back and forth. I wanted 2-minute rounds, 3 rounds, and I wanted to see who the better man was. So then 15 I joined Muay Thai in Philadelphia.
15, that's young.
Yeah.
Because Muay Thai, it's kind of brutal when you watch the pro fights. Did you see that and already know, I want to do that?
I think, dude, back then, like, there wasn't Instagram. YouTube had just come out in 2005, so I didn't have a lot of access to footage.
Yeah.
And mostly was watching, like, Van Damme's Kickboxer.
Yeah.
Tony Jaa's Unbox and that kind of thing. And I was like, okay, I like that. I see that. And then I would watch K1, the kickboxing matches, and boxing.
I used to watch K1 too, yeah.
Yeah, K1, like, Masato era and Bukau and all those guys.
Ernesto Hoos was, like, my favorite.
Yeah, Ernesto, Mr. Perfect.
Yeah.
So watching that, I was like, that's what I want to do. So I did, like, in-house smokers. Then we did, like, tournaments on the East Coast. And then 19, I was like, I want to go to the motherland. I want to go to Thailand and fight. So I did that. Very crazy story. Real quick, I went to go watch one of the trainers fight at the camp that I was training at.
Yeah.
He was like coming out of retirement for the 5th time. He's like 50 something, late 50s.
Yeah.
He was the main event. And then right before he fights, promoter comes up to me and he's like, I hear you want to fight in Thailand. I'm like, yeah, that's why I'm here. And he's like, okay, will you fight him tonight? Oh, tonight.
The guy that's coming out of retirement?
No. So another guy, like he just points at some guy in
like
the crowd.
Like a undercard or something?
Just another guy that was kind of like sitting there watching in the crowd with me. And we kind of lock eyes and we like nod at each other. And
was he warmed up or is he in like civilian clothes?
No,
too?
We both were in civilian clothes. Like
what?
Like jeans and a t-shirt. And I that's why I said, I looked at my coach and I'm like, I don't have a mouthpiece.
That's how they roll in Thailand? Like you and you?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. Especially with the foreigners too, because they know all the, like if they see a Caucasian guy, they know he's there to fight.
That's crazy.
So yeah, it was like 1 a.m., 1:30 in the morning, which is great because we're waking up 5 a.m. training 2-a-days.
So yeah.
Like, I remember I wasn't really nervous for this fight because I was so tired.
You're
like,
so, I was
like, let's get this out of the way because I want to go to sleep.
God.
And really calm in there. And with Muay Thai, I was telling you off camera, it's like a very feeling out process in the beginning. So it's like you ease into it. And in like traditional Muay Thai, like most of these guys are doing it because that's their career. So with Muay Thai, you're not trying to necessarily do damage. You're not trying to hurt someone because you know that's their career. Like if you hurt them, then they're not going to be able to fight next weekend and make money.
So Muay Thai, you're not trying to hurt them.
Depends.
Like you're not trying to like permanently damage your knee.
No, but if I can finish the fight as quickly as possible, doing the least amount of damage, it's a little more respectful, right, to my opponent. If there's animosity, Yeah, they're gonna be smashing each other. Yeah. Elbow wars and cuts and blood and everything. Yeah. But yeah,
like,
man.
Let's talk. You want to talk?
Yeah.
This is number one bullshit. Like that.
Exactly. Yeah. Dipping the hands in broken glass.
Yeah.
So yeah, man. We fought him. I took the fourth round or third round. He dropped me with an elbow. It was the first time I've been ever hit with an elbow. And a spinning elbow.
Oh so my god.
360, boom, I'm on my back, and I see the ref, three refs standing over top, and he's already at 15.
But there's only one ref.
There's only one ref, yeah.
Three, I'm seeing triplets.
Yeah.
Oh man.
So I just spring back up to my feet, and I remember at that point, I'm like, I'm done. Like, I came to Thailand, I'm 19 years old, I came by myself, so I already did enough.
That's
I got in the ring.
Crazy.
But next thing I know, like, he's ushering me towards him. I'm fighting again, I'm just, like, falling all over the place. But yeah, made it to the fourth round, and just kind of pressured him with the hands.
Did you take pre-workout?
I did not.
See?
I
did if you would have said pre-workout.
I would have dodged the elbow.
Yep.
Or he would have broke his elbow on my face.
Lifting basics. Pre-workout.
Okay.
Creatine.
Let me write this down.
Yeah, the sugar-free Monster, the white one, is delicious.
Oh, I like that one, yeah.
Thais don't know about that stuff.
They're all about the Red Bull.
Yeah. So, and then you end up knocking him out?
Yeah, fourth round knockout.
That's great.
Yeah,
you think it was just like, is it like a Rocky situation where it was just heart? Or was it like conditioning? Or?
Yeah, I think it was a little bit of both. I think he probably hit me with that. Wasn't expecting me to get up. Yeah, and he probably, like, adrenaline dump is like, all right, cool, and then sees me get up and, like, you know, kind of like Terminator. I wasn't feeling that way. I was feeling like a little bitch inside, you know, but I just kept going. Like, it was like robotic. My body was moving. And I just remember, like, punching. They're screaming in my corner, like, just 1-2, 1-2. And that's what I did, man.
Sticking to the basics, huh?
Yeah, so I just crossed to the body, hooked to the head, and he didn't get up. So I was like, all right, let's go home.
That's your first pro fight?
Yeah, first and only. It was the only one I've ever had. Yeah, so then I came back, I started doing boxing, Golden Gloves, Mid-Atlantic tournaments in Philly, then moved out 4 years ago to the West Coast, California, did three matches out here.
Just boxing only?
Yeah, just boxing. So you said you want to compete. Do you want to do MMA, boxing?
Oh, no. So I have a couple bucket list things.
Yeah.
One, I want to do an amateur like kickboxing fight.
Okay.
That's one. I want to get a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt. So I know that's going to be like 10, 15, 20 years process.
Yeah, a white belt now?
Zero belt.
Okay.
Yeah.
Invisible belt.
Yeah. From the TV, probably black belt.
Okay, yeah. Instagram black belt.
Yeah, Instagram black belt. Full on MMA where I combine the two. Not too sure where I stand on that yet. But I'm a big fan, I mean, with the transitions, you know, like overhand right to like double leg, like I'm a big fan of, because MMA is its own game. I think people think, oh, if I'm a BJJ black belt and I do striking, you're automatically good at MMA, but there's an entire art form in the transition phase.
Amen.
Yeah, so like, I'm interested in that, but I think the first near goal is the amateur fight, and my coach actually thinks I'm ready for one, for my first one by the end of this year. But I want to be really ready, so I'm thinking maybe by the end of next year.
Yeah.
What kind of nerves, or like what kind of things do I, pretty much what can you tell me to make me not scared? That's what I need to know.
I would say like overtrain your cardio. Like if you feel like your cardio is good, make it even better.
What if your cardio sucks?
then I'd wait till the end of next year,
to do this.
But no, I remember feeling that, and most people will say their first fight, they're like, I thought I had good cardio, I was doing a lot of road work leading up to it, but nerves alone, when you get up there, it's like, you have to imagine you're going to be at 30, 40% of what you're normally at going into the fight before you even start.
Like your heart rate is already...
Yeah, adrenaline dump, people watching, calling your name, other dude on the other side of the ring mean mugging you, and then you got to worry about if you're doing tournaments or amateurs, they may move you around, they'll be like, you're the fourth fight. And then you're all pumped up, you're ready, and then they're like, oh, change of plans, you're gonna be the 12th fight. And then you got that adrenaline, you're ready to go, and then it's like, Ew. And then you gotta build that back up and get pumped up again a second time, and that wears on you, it's tough.
I felt that in a non-life-threatening situation, I used to do stand-up comedy.
Yeah.
And when you go up on open mics and stuff, it's like that.
Yeah.
Like you go there, like, hey, you're 8 o'clock next Tuesday, cool, I bring all my friends.
Yeah.
They come, Dave Chappelle shows up. Guess what? You're 8:30. I'm like, oh, that's fine. Someone else shows up. Joe Rogan shows up. Whatever show. And then by the time you're like performing, it's like 11.
Yeah.
Half the crowd left. Everyone's drunk. And then you have this constant adrenaline, but you still gotta perform your set as best as you can, as if you're doing like Madison Square Garden, you know?
Yeah. Well, that's. I mean, I think.
But no one's punching their face too, though.
Different. But at the end of the day, it's all just mindset. You're still the same person. You're still in the same building. So just remind yourself, I'm just a human being. The guy on the other side of the ring is a human being. He gets nervous too. Mike Tyson got nervous too before every one of his fights. just override it.
I just bite someone in the ear if I get too nervous.
That's all you gotta do, man. As long as you know the ear biting technique, you're good to go.
Are you gonna do a video on that for your Fight Tips channel? Ear biting?
How to bite. The proper way to do it. Dude, that'd be hilarious. We had like a prosthetic ear and just completely bit half of it off.
Yeah, man. Yeah, so today we did mainly a more powerlifting focused workout, and I try to do what I can while incorporating powerlifting into my condition to be in better fight shape. We just did deadlifts for a couple sets of five. Shane really impressed me with how strong he was. He did, at first he was like, oh, I don't really deadlift too much, and they ended up doing 225 for how many reps at the end?
10.
Like 10 reps, they look solid, no belt, no straps, no nothing. That's Thanks. Really, really good. And how much do you weigh?
142 right now, probably.
Yeah, that's really good. Then we did a little circuit with close grip bench, squats, kettlebell swings, dumbbell rows, ab roller.
Yeah, ab roller.
And then we did some kicks on the bag. And for me, like as a powerlifter, you always have, except we don't really move our hips explosively, like unlike an Olympic weightlifter.
Right.
I find that I have poor hip flexibility for one, and it just doesn't move explosively because my sport doesn't demand that on
right.
me. So doing the kettlebell swings first and then throwing the kicks, it really helps me
Interesting.
Out.
Interesting, yeah.
But Shane really helped me get on my toes so I could get more power. Because if you guys see Shane, he's 140, 145, I'm 187. And when he hits the bag, that thing is shaking. So you don't really need like a ton of muscle or power if you know the good technique.
This is true. Yeah. Although you had great kicks, I gotta say.
Oh, thank you.
Tons of power, yeah. I did not want to get hit by them.
Yeah, I just saw you and I was like, and they're stronger and they're faster and I'm like, I'm fucked.
But like you said, it's all about technique.
Yeah.
And if you're dedicating your time to the sport that you're doing, the same thing like playing an instrument. If I'm playing the trumpet, I'm not gonna get better at guitar. If I'm
True.
Powerlifting, I'm not gonna get better at throwing kicks.
True. So
the more time you spend on it, the better you'll be at it.
Yeah. All right, so for Shane's safety, I think we should do one round.
Okay.
I think we should probably do for your safety.
For my safety.
Maybe like 15 seconds. What do you guys think?
A little bit longer.
You got health insurance? Maybe we'll do
You can't monetize it if it's only 15 seconds.
Oh yeah, true, yeah. Okay, for YouTube. Fine, for YouTube, we'll do 1 minute round, which is a lot. But just remember that I have wife and kids, okay? I have wife and kids.
Beautiful wife and kids.
So however you want to absorb that information, remember
He's
that.
Playing mind games. Psychological warfare.
I'm reverse Connor.
Yeah, you're like, issues. So as you can tell, I'm really out of breath. 1 minute's really hard. If you guys ever been in a street fight, you know 15 seconds is hard. Yeah.
But Shane is gonna help me with my hip mobility and show me some stretches. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, sir.
We'll spawn more at David's place for sure.
Okay, sounds good.
Then I'll really kick his ass.
I like his strategy though. Tire out the legs, right? So I can't kick as high.
Yeah.